much for
it's relative, but
democracy and human rights defense over the world. The government of Azerbaijan tries to send a message that we will, as we have, we will silence everyone who dares to challenge us. And I have to say that Khadija joins a long list of people who are on travel ban in Azerbaijan. So when we come to the question, who are allies of bloggers, I can tell you who are my allies. My allies are two very prominent people that most of you know. First is Mr. Aliyev, president of my country, and second, Mr. Putin, president of Russian Federation. And I will tell you why. Because human rights defenders, journalists, activists, for the last two decades, were actually exposing and indicating and showing and telling about this truth in this region, that this region is actually moving in the wrong direction. But nobody was listening to us. So I would like to thank Mr. Aliyev today that he chairs, as dictatorship, Council of Europe, insults and humiliates and undermines the institution that had to be there actually to protect people like Khadija, that this should not have happened, you know. The chair of the Council of Europe today puts a ban on the pride of, I would say, and I wouldn't be ashamed to say this or be shy about it, of international investigative journalists. Who are our allies, and why I said at the beginning that Aliyev and Putin are my allies, because something that I've tried to convince people, the decision makers around the world about Aliyev and about this region for years, these two people helped me a lot, more than any other institution, more than any scholar, I want to see now the scholars who were basically advocating for neoliberal policies in post-Soviet space, saying let's develop business, let's engage them, let's build up businesses, then the middle class will come. Well, I have bad news for you. This part of the world turns now in global security number one for each of you. If you are EU citizen, if you are American citizen, like this is a real threat. And that strategy didn't work. All the papers, all the strategies with engagement, with let's keep doors open, can be thrown out to a dustbin now because just didn't work. Thanks, of course, to Mr. Putin and to Mr. Aliyev.
And Khadija, even so easily said that you can give each council. So today is the reason of this. And I think that if we are talking about government, to say truth, me personally, I'm not really caring about government. Just that I can understand that the first law enforcement body have to care also about Eylem Türkoğlu. But now we are talking about Hatice Ismailova. And also, second question to Emin Milli. It's too easy to sit here and to talk about Aliyev or Putin or whatever. Just a little bit think about and talk about our refugees. More than citizens of your country, more than 1 million. I really ask you about this. Talk about also about our problem, which is very big problem for my organization as well, about Karabakh.
And please invite your friends, and we will have some very distinguished guests visiting this action in the center of Prague. Concerning two of your questions, first about who is Eylem Türkoğlu? I think this is an excellent title for any media now covering the Forum 2000 and the situation in Azerbaijan. This story, I don't want now to go into details of the story. I just want to show that all of you sitting here, you are participating in just small part of excellently organized PR and communication infrastructure. And I actually wonder why we do not have here Brenda Scheffer, or I wonder why don't we here have Matthew Reiser, who is former American ambassador. All the people, the iconic German diplomat who led transition, but unfortunately become a person who basically participates in this PR and communication activities of our increasingly totalitarian government. And this is what happens. The same happens, what you just could observe, the same happened in Council of Europe. This is basically Orwellian newspeak, when you have totalitarian governments creating organizations in the country itself, but also hiring the politicians, organizations who say, well, we are for human rights, we are for peace, we are for conflict resolution, we are for democracy. This was just excellent example of the, what happened, how newspeak entered our life, but all entered the life of Council of Europe and actually of OSCE. You have this sort of dialogues on every event. The second question that do not talk about refugees and the Azerbaijan-Armenian conflict, I will tell you my personal story. Unfortunately, what you see today in Ukraine happened with Donbas and Crimea. This is the same basically scenario, a KGB scenario that happened in Karabakh. This was basically a conflict planted by empire to keep this region dependent from Moscow. You had the same in Georgia with Ossetia and Abkhazia. You had the same in Moldova with Pridnestria. What we see today in Ukraine, that it was exposed so much thanks to technology, bloggers, you know, new media, the entire world could see what was happening in Ukraine. This is exactly how this conflict was engineered between Armenia and Azerbaijan. You know, so I don't believe in nationalism, I don't believe in all these big words. I think that it has been organized, it has been funded, the weapons have been provided to both sides. And of course, the Aliyev and Sargsyan, they are using this conflict to keep themselves in power forever.